It's been way too long since you put yourself out there.
Well, can you blame me?
Well, I wasn't going to bring that up, but since you have...
I've been on one date with Holly. Do you expect everything after a dinner? But before you say anything else, no, I didn't get any kind of Mark vibes from him.
Well, you didn't get any Mark vibes from Mark either.
Don't start. I didn't have to call you at all, you know.
All right, all right. So what's his name?
Jason.
Jason. How'd you two lovebirds meet?
On Tinder. And don't say anything, we both know loads of happy couples that have met on Tinder.
Yeah, and one unhappy one.
Enough, okay? He's not Mark. Didn't you just say you were happy for me getting back out there after nearly 3 years? Isn't this what you want from me? Besides, on our date I even told him a bit about my past, and I didn't get into all the details, you know, didn't want to scare him off, but he seemed genuinely disgusted that I went through what I did, so...
Good. Honestly, I'm surprised you opened up to a stranger so quickly.
Well, we've been talking online for a few weeks, and mostly just superficial flirting, but we've really clicked, and honestly, I partially have you to thank for it, too. All those late-night pep talks after I broke up with Mark, you know, convincing me to stand up for myself from the very beginning.
Good, that's my girl. So what else did you guys talk about?
You know, typical first date stuff. Favorite foods, favorite movies, where we went to school, where we grew up. He's from Oklahoma, actually. Didn't come to New York until after college. And he's got this cute southern charm, paid for our dinner and everything.
Ah, quite the gentleman indeed. So, when do I get to meet him?
Well, let's see how it goes first. He invited me to the movies next weekend, so if it's still going well, you can for sure meet him soon.
Deal. I am really proud of you, Rachel. And happy for you. Sorry, I know I can be a bit...
It's okay. I know it comes from a good place, and honestly, it's earned, so... I'll call you next week.
Deal.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, stranger!
Hi.
I'm just calling to thank you for Mason's birthday present. He absolutely loves it. Not that we needed another loud monster truck toy in the house, but hey, if it gets to be too much, we can always just lose the batteries for a bit.
Oh, well, he's very welcome. I'm glad he likes it. Wish him a happy 5th birthday for me.
You were supposed to do that yourself. I thought you were going to be here today. I haven't heard from you in weeks.
I know. I'm sorry. Work's been so crazy.
Oh, it's okay. How is work going?
Good. Hectic, but good. How about you? How's the family?
Same old. Mason's good. Oh, and Frank actually followed through and made his birthday cake today, which surprisingly wasn't a total disaster.
Oh, I'm glad.
Yeah, it didn't look anything like the dinosaur cake he was going for, but hey, it was green and it was edible. I'm calling that a win.
Nailed it.
So, how's Jason, right?
Jason, yeah, he's good. We're good. Made things Facebook official a few days ago.
Oh, right. I saw that. Congratulations.
Thank you. He's a good guy, Holly. He treats me really well.
Good. I'm so happy to hear that.
Yeah, we even had a conversation a few dates in about my fear of conflict. You know how things with Mark left me, for lack of a better word, traumatized, and how anytime a fight would come up, I'd just collapse in on myself and make things as manageable as possible? Well, with Jason, it's different. You know, we don't fight, like, at all, and... It feels incredible, like a relationship should, you know?
Yeah, I suppose. But I mean, Rach, it is normal to argue sometimes, just not for things to escalate like how Mark made them.
Yeah, for sure. I know. But for now, this is really working for us. And anytime we feel something coming up, we just take a step back and distance ourselves. And it's all very mature.
Sounds like it. But then you come back and sort things out later when you're more level-headed, right?
Yeah, if the comes back up.
That's great, Rach. Anyways, I have to get the little stinker in the bath and ready for bed, but we're still definitely on next month for your birthday, right? It's been way too long, and I miss my best friend. Plus, I want to make sure that this new man isn't only treating her right, but isn't just a figment of her imagination.
Oh, come on.
Hey, stranger things have happened in Rachel Land. Oh, come on, you know I'm just yanking your chain. But seriously, no bailing on me again, okay?
Deal. Night, Holly.
Night. Ah, she lives.
Okay, I deserved that.
I don't know what you mean.
Yes, it's been a couple of months, and yes, I bailed on having a birthday party when I promised I'd see you.
Rachel, I don't want to be in this situation any more than you do, but this was your idea, remember? Remember what happened the last time I stopped hearing from you regularly? Okay, stupid question, but that's why we put these weekly calls into place. Last time I stopped hearing from you, I found you on death's door at the hospital after Mark tried to use you as a damn punching bag.
I know. I'm sorry.
No, don't apologize to me. This is about you. Making sure that you're okay. You're only letting yourself down. Look, you know I worry about you, but if these weekly calls are too much and you don't think you need it anymore, then we can talk about that.
I know. I'm sorry. Right. Look, I love our calls and keeping up to date with you and your life. I need to get better at following through. You know, it's more than just a check-in. And look, I promise they're not needed from a safety perspective anymore, okay? Jason and I are doing great, and he's never laid a hand on me, and I will never let him.
Good. Rachel, you know, it'd be easier to believe you if I'd actually met the guy. Or if you didn't feel the need to keep reassuring me that everything's great.
You'll meet him soon enough and see for yourself. But for now, I promise on my mother's grave, everything is fine.
Your mom's still alive, Rachel.
Okay, fine. How about my unborn child? Is that good enough for you?
What?
Surprise! Look, I know it's a lot, but it's why I haven't been in touch and why I haven't gotten around to seeing you, so.
I don't know what to say.
You could say, congratulations, that you're happy for me.
Of course. Of course I'm happy for you, Rachel. But
it's fast. But we're not married, but you haven't even met Jason yet. I get it. It wasn't exactly planned, but you'll be happy to know that we had a conversation, you know, me not avoiding conflict and actually sat down and had a deep and difficult discussion with my boyfriend of 5 months about our future and our baby.
And
he's excited. I mean, it's not necessarily what he would have expected or maybe wanted either, but he says he's there for me for the long haul and that he wants to raise the baby with me, and he never even considered any alternative.
By that, you mean?
Yes, an abortion. Look, he said it would never be an option for us, and honestly, it made me feel more solid, you know, about this decision in us. And
that's great, Rachel. How are you feeling?
Physically, I feel like shit, but apparently that's par for the course. Haven't been throwing up a lot at least, so hopefully that sticks. But thank you for supporting me. It means more than you know to have your approval, and I know you're just looking out for me, but sometimes it feels like you are harder on me than my own mom. Do you know that? Like, do you mean it? Are you really happy for me?
Of course I am. Anyone that knows you knows how long you wanted to be a mom. And you'll be a great one. Just promise me that I get to meet the father of your child before I meet your child.
You will. Sooner rather than later. On that note, what are you doing September 10th?
I don't tend to make plans 3 months ahead of time, but I should be free. Why?
Because we're getting married. Just a small civil ceremony with everything that's happening, you know, just a few friends and immediate family, but I was really hoping you'd be my maid of honor.
Of course I will. I'll be there. I wouldn't miss it for anything.
Well, that's a relief. I'm so excited for the two of you to finally meet and for you to help me plan this wedding. There's not a lot of time to get it together. And hey, if you have another baby soon, we could they could grow up and be best friends. And okay, I'm getting ahead of myself, but thanks. I'll call you next week with more details, okay? I love you.
I love you too, sweetie.
Bye. Hi.
Hey, Miss Newlywed Bride. How was the honeymoon?
Oh, it was great.
When did you guys get back?
Last weekend. Sorry I didn't call you sooner.
Tell me everything.
It was so relaxing. Just what I needed. Laying by the beach, long walks, swimming, eating way too much food.
Hey, you're eating for two. You're allowed.
Yes, that is what Jason and the resort staff kept telling me when I was feeling guilty. There was one incident where we tried to go to a restaurant on the way home and Jason refused to wear a mask, but...
Sounds like Jason.
He didn't make that big of a deal of it, though. You know, we went somewhere else where he didn't need one, and, you know, seriously, overall it was lovely.
Good. Rachel Jr. didn't give you too much trouble?
Well, we don't know if it's a Rachel Jr. or a Jason Jr. yet.
Ah, when do you find out?
Anytime. I had my ultrasound on Wednesday, and they said they'd call me with the results. A little surprised they haven't called yet, but...
Well, that's exciting. What are you hoping for?
I think it's a girl, but Jason really thinks it's a boy, so...
Oh, shocker.
Of course, we'll love it no matter what.
Of course. I am really happy for you, Rachel. Seriously, I know that I can dole out a little bit of tough love sometimes, but... I've grown to see you like a little sister, and I just want what's best for you. We all do. And I'm so glad to see that you found it.
Thanks. It feels so surreal. You know, it just happened so fast.
For sure. But that feeling will pass, and it'll feel pretty darn real soon enough. Just try to enjoy this time. Enjoy being pregnant, because as soon as that little one comes out, everything's going to be different. Oh, that reminds me, I still need a few more details for planning your baby shower. Where are we at with picking a few dates and writing out a preliminary guest list so I can send it back to the venue?
Oh, hold that thought. My OB is calling. I'm just going to mute you for a sec, okay?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Crossing my fingers hard for a girl over here. Jason be damned.
All right, thanks. I'll let you know.
Rachel, there you are. What the hell? I've been trying to get a hold of you all weekend. What's going on? Are you okay?
The OB called me.
Yes, I know. And? Come on, if you're calling me in the middle of the night, it can't be good. I'm here for you. What is it, a boy, girl? Everything okay?
Advanced preeclampsia.
What?
That's what the doctor said.
What is that?
I don't know exactly, but from what she told me, it means I can't carry the baby safely to term.
What do you mean? Is the baby okay?
Basically right now, yes. But she said if I go through with the pregnancy, it will most likely kill me.
Oh, Jesus, Rachel.
so sorry. What are you going to do?
I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do. I haven't been able to catch my breath since she called, let alone think straight.
Well, of course. I'm sorry. You need time to process. What does Jason think?
I can't.
Come on, Rachel. What did he say? You haven't told him yet, have you? There's Rachel, there's avoiding conflict, and then there's... I don't even know what this is. He's the baby's father. He's your partner. He's the one that you should be talking to about this right now, not me.
I know, but you don't understand.
Where is he right now?
He's at a neighbor's election party waiting for the results. I tried to talk to him, but...
Shit, has the election...
Nothing yet, as far as I know.
Right, sorry, this isn't about that right now. So what did the doctor say in terms of a timeline? I hate to be blunt, Rachel, but it sounds like you're going to have to think about, you know, sooner rather than later.
I know.
Did she talk about the chances of your baby being saved?
There's a small chance, but it's too early, so probably won't be good.
Shit. I'm sorry, Rachel. This is so unfair. Just promise me that you and Jason will talk about it tomorrow morning and do what needs to be done. This is your life that you're gambling with here.
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I can't talk to Jason about it again. I'm sorry. It's why I called you, okay? You were fucking right. You were fucking right, like always. And you wouldn't...
Rachel, what are you talking about? Right about what?
I'm scared, Holly. I don't know what to do.
It's okay. I'm here. I'll talk you through this.
Oh, God.
Rachel, what was that? Are you all right? What's going on? What do I hear in the background?
Holly, can you turn on the news?
Why?
Just do it, okay?
In what can only be described as a surprising comeback in the 2020 federal election, we have received early reports that Donald J. Trump has been very narrowly won a second term as president of the United States.
No.
Donald Trump.
God, no. Fuck. Damn it. No. Wait, Rachel, is that hearing that I hear? Is that Jason? Jesus Christ, what kind of election party was he at? Did you know that that bastard was a Trump supporter? You knew that there was something off about him. Shit. No wonder you don't want to tell him that you need an abortion. Who knows the debate he's on?
I tried to talk to him about it tonight, but he wouldn't listen, and he got so angry. He told me he'd help me see things straight when he came home, and while he was coming back.
Okay, hey, Rachel, here's what's going to happen, okay? Here's what I need you to do, okay? I want you to hang up. And I want you to pack a bag of your essentials, call an Uber, and then come straight to my place, okay?
He's not gonna let me go. He won't let me go. You should see him. He was just like...
Rachel, listen to me. Hide from him if you have to. I don't want him to get the chance to see you and stop you. We need to get you out of there soon. We can get you to a doctor tomorrow. Jesus, he knows how much work. Eagle now with... Wait, shit, no. We can't think about that right now.
What am I gonna... Like,
raising the baby with you is your only option, isn't it? God, I thought he was being a gentleman.
What are we gonna do? He's not gonna let me get help. I've never seen the side of him. I saw tonight. And... Holly, you told me he was gonna make me have the baby no matter what.
Okay, Rachel. Listen to me, okay? This is life and death, okay? Do you understand me? You need to pull yourself together, even for a little while, until you're safe, okay? I'm here for you. We just take care of you now, okay? I brought you. It's like after Mark, okay? I brought you. I just need you to get to, okay? Just promise me that you'll come over. Right over, okay? Promise me that you'll call me when you're in the Uber? On your way? Rachel? Rachel! Rachel? Thank you.